Well, hello again. This is part three of carving this rose. And I hope I got a little better view today so you can actually see what I'm doing. We're still working on the deepest part, trying to get the sky. Trying to get the sky first. It's always the deepest part. Notice where I've got this finger and that tip is never in line, because if you don't want to do that, So you got to watch what you're, keep a close eye on how you handle these sharp tools. It's a good cloudy day, so this is a nice way to pass the time. We didn't have cell phones when I was a kid. We had to find other ways of having fun, and this was one of them. Anyway, you can see what I'm trying to achieve here. We're going to take all this sky down to an equal limit. And I'm going to try to limit this whole series to maybe 6 episodes for time's sake. So basically, these first 3 showing you how it starts. So you can see we're getting down to the level. And once we get there, we'll take a different tool and we'll smooth it out. We'll take all those ridges out and it'll be a smooth sky. And then once we get the sky, I'll show you how to add the birds and whatever else you want to put in there. But see, different tools will give you a different effect. And you can see how you can get that smoother, take all these ridges off. Anyway, to save time, I've got a sample of what you're trying to achieve here. This is what you're trying to do. Here's your sky. Here's your ground. And then your rose comes up out of that wood. Here's your stem, your leaves. This is what we're trying to achieve with this. So. Takes a little time, but it's fun. You can carve just about anything. If you can think it and draw it, you can carve it. Just make sure the wood you have doesn't have any knots in it. Make sure it's good, knot free. This came from Hobby Lobby. Not to give them a plug, but they have different sizes and shapes. And or you can just grab any kind of piece of wood and put an idea on there and work on it. Sometimes it's good therapy too. After my wife died of COVID, I really got back into this to help me with the grieving process, you might say. And I started carving things for the whole family and a few for myself. So I would ask what the person was interested in, and they would tell me, and I would try to sketch it out and carve it and eventually send it to them. So with that in mind, I was pretty much thinking about how lonely it was going to be after she'd gone to heaven. So I took that whole thought and I sketched it out. And this is what I come up with. This is a... there's a cabin with Rusty and a rocking chair. And there I am fishing in the creek. Creek runs under the covered bridge. We got a tire swing out in the backyard, and it's sitting on a hill. And we'll get to the part to where we shade all this with a wood burning tool. I'll show you how that's done too. And we got a eagle sitting on a carved out tree stump. A couple of doves over here flying over the creek. This was just a thought. And you draw it out and take your time. You got your sky level. Again, the lowest point. Then you got your mountains or your hillside. A little bit not as low. And then you leave what you want highlighted to stand out. You just barely want to carve on that. Like the cabin, you leave that coming up, the tree you'll bring up, the bridge comes up, me sitting on a stump comes up, and Rusty on the front porch, he comes up just a little bit, just enough to where you can see there's something there. And then the birds, they're just burnt into the sky. You can carve them in, but it's real delicate, and they might end up breaking off. You slip, and then you've wasted a lot of time, so I just burn them in. But you try to add depth in your scenery. But that was a feeling kind of a bit alone, so I had to throw that on a piece of wood. It's just an old hunk of wood. And of course you gotta date it and sign it and put a hole in it so you can hang it on the wall. Yeah, that come out pretty good. So I'm going to go ahead and get all this carved, and then the next time we meet I'll have the wood burner heated up and we'll attempt to shade and make this thing look worthy enough to hang on your wall. Thank you for watching, and God bless you.